Hi, in this tip, I'd like to talk a little bit about the normal tools. So when I say the normal tools, what I mean are the polygon tools that are prefixed with the word normal. If I select a few polygons, and then I right click, I see I have normal move, normal scale, normal rotate. It took me a while to grasp what these tools did when I first started to use Cinema 4D. But as long as you get the concept of a normal, it gets pretty clear. And this is a really cool tool. It can allow you to create shapes like this one really quickly. And it also allows you to adjust the surfaces of certain polygonal models in ways that you normally wouldn't be able to easily adjust. So this axis right here is the normal of this polygon. It's the blue part sticking out. And it's oriented to this polygon. If I select a different polygon, its normal faces a different way. So if I were to select a group of polygons right here and use the normal move tool, it's going to move each polygon along its normal. Now, that seems pretty unimpressive right there, but it goes a little bit further than that. You can do a normal rotate, which might look a little bit more impressive at this scale, but it still sort of leaves you wondering, what would I use that for? So let me show you how to create that funny looking blob that I showed you earlier. You could start off with a sphere. I'm going to turn on the wireframe mode. And what we can do is change it to a icosahedron. So when we have this kind of sphere, we can just convert it to editable polygons, and then I'm just going to start to select a few sort of star-shaped patches. I don't want to spend too much time doing this, so I'm going to be really sloppy about which ones I select. I'm just going to make sure the distribution is somewhat even. So I'm just going to select some of these, maybe one up here, and one more down there. So we have these patches selected all over this sphere. Now, it's pretty much 3D modeling 101 to understand that you can move these around, or you can extrude from them, so we can push the polygons out. But it's kind of annoying sometimes when you push the polygons out like this and they get larger. Notice they get larger as you push them out just because of the way that tool works. So what we're doing right here is kind of a normal move, but it's creating new geometry along the way, which is why it's an extrude. So what we can do is we can then say, okay, what about a normal scale? So we can scale down, and each group of faces scales by itself. So that's where the power comes in. We can then do another extrude operation, and maybe we wanted to do a normal scale again to make them a little skinnier. And then we could do maybe an extrude inner operation, which will allow us to extrude perpendicular like that. And then maybe a normal move again, which allows us to push those polygons forward. And then maybe we extrude. And then do another extrude inner. And then we can extrude again. But pretty soon we're going to intersect geometry, as you're seeing there. So what we can do is, after we extrude, we can do a normal scale. So you're beginning to see how powerful this is, that it lets you modify groups of geometry that have nothing to do with each other than they're all selected. So now we can scale that in and scale it in all the way to the center. So what we're left with is this sort of object where we've been able to do the exact same modeling routine all over the surface of it. And we can give it a fancy color. I didn't realize you could do that. Looks like it tried to apply it just to that one polygon. Yeah, so we can give it a fancy color, and then we can just drop it in a hypernurbs object. So we just place the sphere as a child, and you get this sort of object. In the other project here that I showed you, I actually applied a little bit of simple animation to it, but perhaps that's going to be a different 5-minute tip when I show you guys how to make that. So that's all well and good if what you want to create is organic, funky-looking blobs like this. But what if you wanted to make some legitimate modifications to some rigid angular geometry? Well, the normal tools can help you there as well. So I'm just going to switch over to another project, moving groups of polygons. This might look familiar. It was one of my pipe tutorials. And here's how we can use normal move for this. So what if we wanted to make these groups, this group of polygons right here, smaller? Well, we'd have to scale them. But if we scale them, we're kind of limited in how we scale, because notice the axis here is kind of not aligned with it. So we can scale on the X, or we can scale on the Z. None of them really work. But if we scale on all the axes, it sort of pinches it down. That's not what we want either. We can actually use normal move to move all of these polygons inward or outward. And we can use normal scale to move them all like that. So right there, it's really powerful if it's used on a group of polygons that come right back around and close a loop. Another way you can use this is, okay, all of these bends right now have the same distance at the sides of them. They all have a similar length. I'm just gonna quickly select all of them. And I'm going to create a polygon selection. And then I'm going to create a new material, maybe something orange. And we can apply that second material only to the selection we set. Okay, so you can see that there's really long segments at the end of each of these joints. Now, we did all the work of creating these joints. It would be a real shame to have to model them all over again. But the normal tools can actually help us. So what I can do is I can use my rectangular selection tool, and I'm just going to select all of the faces at the edges of these joints. So, oops, selected too much there. So I have all of these faces, these orange ones at the sides, selected. Now, there's really no other way to move all of them all together other than using the normal tools. So what I can do is I can say normal move, and I can actually move all of them along their normals to make them all longer or shorter. So it's a really powerful tool. You could also use it to give them a bit of a flare. If I use the loop selection, and I just select that loop of polygons at the edge of each one, I can use the normal move tool again to make it a bit fatter and give them all sort of a flare. So they almost look like rubber connectors now instead of hard, rigid connectors. So I hope you enjoyed that tip, and I'd appreciate any feedback. So if you liked it and you want to see more like this, let me know. Just leave me a comment. And until next time, see ya.